background because I want to unload the dishwasher. But I just thought about talking about this because somebody told me on my other channel that Kevin Simpson told me he's from Birmingham, I believe. Birmingham has some of the most amazing British bands of like all time. So anyway, I was really sad to hear that Graeme Edge had passed away. I mean, he was so cheeky though. He was quintessential British. Just he had a very cheeky sense of humor and just like he would have all these different quips. I used to look at some of his posts on Facebook. It'd been a few years, but then I heard he passed away, so it kind of just made me think about, like, I'm playing the Moody Blues in the background. Hopefully this doesn't get demonetized or blocked for playing it. But you know what? I'm going to play it tonight because I'm just having a thought about, like, bands that you like old bands that have gone away, like, because members have passed away and they're not going to be alive, like, forever. It kind of makes you think about that. And, these are some songs from one of the earliest albums I remember when I was a child that my mom played for me on a record called Days of Future Past. And it was just so beautiful and amazing. And I remember being a child and she took out her record because back then people had records, okay? And she would play this, and just the words were just so beautiful. And, you know, I do like some hard rock bands. I do, like the Scorpions and whatnot. And I do like metal music, like the real kind of metal music, not like the modern stuff. But I love the Moody Blues because they're a little bit more on a calm. I'm not saying that they're exactly prog rock. They're kind of hard to place, actually. The Moody Blues are very interesting. I think they're very British, actually, in a way, because a lot of things, a lot of the lyrics, a lot of the things that British singers sing about, like in their songs, it goes back to folklore, things in British, because there is British culture, you know. I think there's a lot of that in some of their songs and some of their songwriting, but when it comes to Graeme Edge, what was it about him? He was a great drummer. Amazing drummer, okay? But his recitations of poetry, oh my gosh, you know, Mike Pinder. I know Mike Pinder and Graeme Edge kind of had their disagreement and their feud, but Days of Future Past will always remain a wonderful, wonderful album because it was so innovative for the time. First off, it was the first time that a rock band had played with an orchestra. Well, it was an ensemble. It was like a collection of classical musicians, but it's just really beautiful. Days of Future Past, I love it. This one is not my favorite, but it's from 1967. Anyway, I'm blocked for playing it. I'm probably not supposed to play it, but the sunset. I'm gonna okay. So it's just really beautiful. It's really, really beautiful, and it's very calling, very existential. Now, each of the guys had their own music style. I would say Justin Hayward was the lyricist of the band. But yeah, I really liked Graeme Edge. Oh, everybody stopped watching. I guess this wasn't that exciting. Well, I don't know. We'll see. I like this one because it's kind of Middle Eastern sounding. city goes down. Time begun with a sunset. And Ray Thomas was a beautiful flutist. Oh my gosh. My favorite one is Nights in White Satin. The most famous one, Nights in White Satin. Nights in White Satin, never reaching the end. Letters are written, never meaning to send. Beauty of always past, were these eyes before? Just what the truth is, I can't say anymore. 'Cause I love you, oh. Yes, I love you, oh. Some hand in hand, just what they're going through, they can't understand. Trying to tell me thoughts they cannot defend, just what you want to be. You will be in the end. I love you, water. Yes, I love you, water. I love you, water. I love the flute. Too much fun on a Friday night doing dishes. Just having a good night. Good music, good time. You know, I just feel like it's really important. Like, life is really short. It's just so precious. It's so important. And, like, I've just gotten, to the point in my life where I realized I had this epiphany that I want to appreciate the things that brought me joy and happiness, like listening to the Moody Blues, things of that nature. There's so much negativity in this world, and I guess it just depends on what are you going to let be your driving force? Are you going to look for the negative in everything all the time? Or are you going to maybe have the audacity to think, maybe there's still good things out there? I think there are still good things out of there, but sometimes you just have to look for them in things that you remember and reminisce, and things that brought meaning and purpose to your life. And I don't know, that's how deep I feel about the Moody Blues. Yes, I feel that way about the Moody Blues. Music touches me like that. And it's so beautiful. Like, is there anything that's this beautiful today? There just isn't. Sorry, I just don't think there is anymore. Like, I know there's some beautiful music, but I'm talking about, like, what's, like, trending. Like, this is just amazing. I love you. Dishwasher. I always rinse everything out before it goes in the dishwasher. The dishwasher is really only good for sanitizing. I'm sorry, but I find it does not get food off. You kind of just need to rinse it. But it's good for sanitizing for sure, but you do need to do some rinsing. Like, and after I film myself doing a big load of dishes, I'll make a fun video because I decided to do more cleaning videos. I'm finding a lot of and just excitement and cleaning and things like that. This is just my opinion. I feel like there's a lot of people in this world, they don't feel good about themselves for some reason. And they have to find something to make others feel bad too. Like, they want to make others feel the same way that they do for some reason. Like, to bring others down. And I guess you have to choose. You have to select what you want to do. And personally, I'm kind of tired of that whole game. Like, people. This is useless energy spent. This is Graeme Edge. Lovers, this is fun. Hi, love one. How's it going? Some citizens wish they were young. And he was young when he said this, and now he has passed away. It was a night.
The colors from our side. Red is gray, yellow and white,
which is illusion. We decide which is right and which is an illusion. It's so beautiful. Yes, Graeme Edge, you had a very cheeky British sense of humor, and I feel delighted thinking about how this band had such an impact on my life. A good one. Good memories. I don't have time for the negativity or things that people are looking to bring themselves down. I think when you start looking for the positive things in life, you'll feel better. That's my opinion. But anyway, those are just some of my thoughts, and I kind of feel sad to hear that Graeme Edge passed away, but I think he lived a full, boisterous life. He was quite a character. He was very British. But yeah, and the Moody Blues will still be one of my favorite bands. I don't always listen to them all the time, but I was kind of in the mood because somebody had told me about it on one of my videos, my other video on my other channel. Anyway, thanks for watching. I need to turn it off.